Hello everyone. So in this video, let's refactor our rest of the code. So we are using Nest.js with the typo RM, and we have done the cleanup of our auth controller. So these are the existing routes. We just converted them into the typo RM compatible controller and services. So we have this user services find by login. So find by login, we are passing username password. We are doing a find one based on username. If user exists, then we are comparing the password of that user object. Otherwise, we are just saying invalid credential. While creating the user, we are getting the username and password in the user DTO. First of all, we are checking the username. So this dot user repo dot find one. And how we are accessing the user, how we are getting the user repo? By injecting the repository, inject repository user, we are accessing the user repo dot find one. Now, we have other methods also, like we were using JWT strategy. So if you see this code, once user is logged in and he received a token and now he is coming back. So we are using JWT strategy for it. And this JWT strategy we might be using as a middleware in our routes. So in main.ts, this is our main module. So here we will define that what all routes should pass through this JWT strategy. So in this, we are just having this simple, it is going to extract this access token from the header, and secret key we are already passing in the environment. Now, once this token is validated, then we will get a payload. So how we are generating a token first? If you see the login, we are passing the payload as a username. So the token is being generated from the username object. This is the username object we are passing. If you see the sign payload method, here we are passing the payload and we are just passing the expiry and the secret key. Now, when you are doing a verification of this payload, then first what we are doing is first token is verified. Now, in this payload, we will get the username again. And here again, we have to verify that user still exists in database or not. Okay, so here for that, we are doing a validate user. In this payload, we are going to get the username. So find by login, and we are passing the okay. So here we can just create a method find by username, because this payload has only username. Okay, this new method we can define in the service. Find by username, and here it will be a username as a string you will get. So we'll just wrap it around a try catch first of all, and what we can do is let's clean this up. Yeah, so find by username. So here we are just trying to do is just user repo dot find one based on this username. If user exists, that is fine. Otherwise, user does not exist. We have to type a fully user does not exist in system, and here we can just say unauthorized. Okay, so user does not exist in system, find by user. Once the token is validated, we are validating the username also, that username is there in system or not. Otherwise, we are just saying unauthorized exception. Okay, this is how we are done with our auth service. Auth service is just generating a token and validating a token or validating the user. All these things we are doing with this auth service. Okay, auth service is using the user service. We use the service as a part of shared module. So how it is able to access it then? In the shared module, we are exporting first user service, and here in this module, we are injecting the shared module. I mean, we have defined the dependency of shared module. So all the services which are exported from shared module can be accessed in the auth service, can be accessed in the services defined in the auth module. So here I'm injecting user service and I can access it. So this is about our basic login registration. So our auth module is done and shared module is done. Now what we can do is we can create a post controller, because user is logged in, right? Now user is logged in and user is coming back with the access token in the header, because what we are doing is here we are checking that user is coming back with the access token or not. So validate user, find by username, sorry, user service, find by username, and here we are doing find one, and we should be returning user, which we are not doing right now. So what we can do is we can return user, and here we are writing TypeScript, and also you can just do what we are returning is promise entity user. All these methods, find by login. Find by login is returning the object. Okay, so all these you can just add. So it is returning a promise of type user. So you can just define what this particular method is returning based on what operation you are performing. Okay, find by login, find username. This looks fine now. So here we got the user object. Now let me just check. Oh, it is complaining. So try return try catch. So validate user is returning us. So this method is returning a promise of user. Okay, coming back to strategy, argument of type user is not assignable to parameter of type. Okay, this we need to check now. So it is returning this. What just happened? Try the exception. Okay, this is the first callback. If user is not found, we are returning this exception, and we are returning null as a user object. Now you are clear how we are defining the auth service and user service, and we are able to access everything. Now in the next video, we can create our post controllers, command controller, tag controller, category controller, and you can just create these separate modules. Like we have created a shared, so you can create another folder. Here you can create a post module. I think we have already created a post folder. So post module, so here you will be accessing the post entity, right? Type rm module dot post entity. Just fix the import statements. Now that is done, and now we'll have post service, post controller, and post service here. Post service will do all the type rm related operation for this particular post. Okay, that we will see in the next video. Thanks everyone.